गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस स्टार्ट सिविक्स नाउ. वी विल स्टार्ट विद द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स, डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी. आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इट गेव्स ऑब्जेक्टिव टू द पीपल, टू द इंडियन रिपब्लिक, एंड दीज ऑब्जेक्टिव्स वेयर एज वी हैव लर्न इन द लास्ट चैप्टर वेयर जस्टिस, फ्रीडम, इक्वालिटी, फ्रेटर्निटी एंड मेनी अदर थिंग्स. The constitution has also ensured some fundamental rights for the Indian citizenship, and those fundamental rights are the right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational right, and right to constitutional remedy. Other than the fundamental rights, our constitution also has given us few directive principles. What are directive principles? These principles are the guidelines which were issued by the Indian Constitution and are used by our government lawmakers to be kept in mind when they make any kind of rules and regulations for the people of the country. Directive principles. This concept was itself taken from the Irish Constitution, and by their influence, the Indian Constitution also has implemented directive principles. These principles include Gandhism, they include social justice, they include economic welfare, they include foreign policy, and they include other administrative matters. Why are these directive principles important? Because they lay down the foundation of economic democracy, that is, government is for the people, by the people, and of the people. Directive principle, they establish welfare of the state, of the whole state. These principles supplement fundamental rights, guiding all the lawmakers. They bring stability and continuity in state policies, and they also give a educative value to the lawmakers. Moving on to Gandhian principles. According to Gandhiji, the state shall promote educational and economic interest of weaker sections. That means the weaker or the minority sections should be uplifted. Can be SCs and STs. It prevented consumption of liquor and all the kinds of intoxicating drinks to improve the public health. It also influenced in organizing village panchayat. It encouraged cottage industries, that means people could get employment in small rural areas. In their houses also they could have their own employment. It improved agriculture and encouraged animal husbandry. According to Gandhian principles, free and compulsory education has to be provided for all the children who are below 14 years. Coming to social and economic principle, it ensured that the state that adequate means, that means equal means of livelihood to the people, fair distribution of nation's wealth, okay, that means equally the nation's wealth should be distributed. Equal pay for men and women. No discrimination could be made on the basis of sex and religion, caste, creed. Children to be protected against exploitation, that no child can be exploited. To ensure right to work, right to education, and right to state assistance in case of unemployment. The state is directed to provide living wage to its people. The state should ensure participation of workers in the management of their factories. That means all the people living in the state should get opportunities to work. The state has to provide adequate living wages to its people. Moving on next, let me discuss with you other important principles. As in sense, organization of agriculture, protection and improvement of environment and safeguarding forest and the wildlife, protection of monuments and other national heritage is also our directive principle, separation of judiciary from executive, that the judiciary form of government and executive form of government both are at most independent forms of government. It promoted international peace and security and honored relations among nations. It encouraged settlement of international disputes between the states and the countries. The international principle promoted international peace and security to maintain honorable relations between states in the world and the countries in the world. The states should endeavor to promote respect between international treaties which were signed, agreement which were made between countries. The country has to strive to settle down international distributions and any kinds of problems and disputes which arise has to be settled down peacefully. Comparing directory principles and fundamental rights. Directory principles are non-enforceable in any court of law. They are non-questionable. Fundamental rights are enforceable. That means anyone's fundamental rights are violated can seek the help of the court. The government cannot take decisions on rights and directory principles. The government has powers to make policy decisions. In fundamental rights, there is political democracy. And in directory principles ensure social and economic democracy of the people. They are natural rights for the individual. And these are directory principles which are for the lawmakers of our country. Directory principles are implemented for the abolition of zamindari system, to have a clear 5-year plan of the government, to have a welfare for the weaker sections of our society, that means can be minor children, women, SC, STs, other backward classes, to provide free and compulsory education to children till the age of 14, welfare of the whole country, and equal rights for women. That is all for this chapter. I hope you understand the chapter. Please go through the book once again. Thank you, children.